Don't adjust your sets. I know what you're thinking. Have they cloned Gary? I know we look like identical twins, but I'm joined by Jake for this series of videos looking at steel conduit that can help you if you're just getting into the trade, maybe as an apprentice, or maybe you're an electrician whose conduit skills are a little rusty. Like how I did that one. So what do you want to start with then?
So we'll start with looking at the conduit bender first, looking at the different parts of it and transporting it as well.
Transporting it, and that's a big one for me. So whenever I lifted it around a workshop or got it out of the back of the van, the arm would swing freely, hit me in the shin, and the legs would open out. When you brought this one in, it didn't seem to do so, did it?
Mine doesn't do that. There we go.
That's a cracking start, isn't it? Shall we see how that is then?
Yep. So we've got two pins. One's holding the handle, and this one is stopping the bender from opening up, so there we go.
That seems too simple, doesn't it? So it's those two there. We're in position in the appropriate holes, stopping it obviously when transporting it from flying open.
Yep.
So what do you would like to start with? What you can explain to me first?
So we'll start with the handle. Some people might call this the roller bar.
Okay, yeah.
And we've got the roller itself.
I noticed there's some other holes there, so it can be moved to position. What's the thinking behind that?
Yep, so that can be adjusted depending on the size of conduit that we're bending. 20, 25, 32, for example.
Okay, yeah, and this thing here, what would you call this?
And that's the former. This is a 20mm former at the moment that we've got in, and this is the stop. So if we insert a piece of conduit, you can see that stops it from flying up in the air.
Ah, right, so again, the reason there's several holes in here, I suppose, as this conduit gets larger from 20, 25, 32, you could actually bring it up the holes in
that's
the stop
right,
itself.
Yeah.
Right, the former you said was a 20mm former. I noticed there is another one attached to one of the legs.
Yep, we've got a 25mm former down there.
And
really
is it
easy to swap out.
Oh, right, okay.
Yep. We'd remove that. That simply slides out. Easy as that.
So now we're ready for 25mm, that
That's
was
right.
easy. Yeah, okay, so that former's now in for 25mm conduit, and it might be a case now of you move your stop up one position.
That's right, yeah.
As I'm looking at the legs in relationship to the voice that's attached to the conduit bending machine, it seems to be at a little bit of an angle. What's the thinking behind that?
Yep, so you'll see why when we insert a piece of conduit. This is a different vice, Gary, as well. This is a round jaw vice.
Okay, so why is that?
So obviously traditional vice is usually flat, that could crush or flatten the conduit slightly. We don't want that to happen, and that will happen with a round jaw vice.
Ah, that makes sense. So often at colleges you see those square jaw vices on benches. So if you start putting this conduit in it, you can actually crush it flat.
Correct, yeah.
Now with it being higher and lower, so this being the higher end here, which end do I end up working on?
If we're going to work from the higher end, you can imagine this would normally be a longer piece of conduit. We don't want to be down bending down low to cut and thread that. We want to be working from the higher end.
Okay, and you're going to show us in a later video how to cut and thread conduit properly as well. So they're the key elements of our conduit bending machine. Where are you going to take us next?
So we've looked at the basics of the conduit bender. We're going to use this in this series of videos, and we're going to look at bending a range of different conduit bends.
So you're going to do for me a 90 degree bend, you're going to do double sets, swan necks or bubble sets, you can do back to back bends,
yep.
You can do a bend and a set.
I'm going to do everything, yeah.
I'd like to say thank you for that. Okay, so that's all going to come up in this series of videos. And we'd like your comments and feedback. Please leave those below. Is there a bend you want to see Jake do? Okay, it's one that you're struggling with on site or maybe struggling with at college. Is there anything that we've called the items on the conduit bending machine that you've got another name? We'd like to know those names, especially if we move through this series of videos. And we'll try and get back to, or I'll let Jake actually get back to as many comments as he can.